it's very good to be with you, even if it's in this particular format, in Remembrance Tide. Warm greetings from all those who live and work here at York Minster. I'm standing in Deans Park, which is one of my favourite places. It's a great place, one of those places that you can sit and think and reflect and chill out, remember the things that matter most and get reconnected. I'm standing also in front of the War Memorial in Deans Park, and I want to draw attention to one part of it, the memorial that commemorates the Battle of Kohima, part of the Burma campaign. The Battle of Kohima involves the incredible heroism of a small company of men and women who resisted thousands of Japanese imperial troops. The numbers are staggering. We're thinking of hundreds resisting thousands. They did this for 16 days under continual bombardment with some of the most fierce hand-to-hand fighting of the Second World War. We remember those who gave their lives in a battle often known as the Battle of the Tennis Court, because that's really where it ended up, on the Deputy Commissioner's tennis court next to where his bungalow would have been. We remember those who've given their lives that we might live. In parables and in other teaching too, Jesus often reminds us and challenges us to be awake. There's a great parable, one of his stories, about some foolish bridesmaids who run out of oil for their lamps as they snooze waiting for the bridegroom to come. And Jesus is saying something like this, that when the moment of God's kingdom comes, when the moment to speak up for love, when the moment to act justly comes, you must be awake and ready. Not like those foolish bridesmaids who didn't prepare well and ran out of oil at the crucial moment. When the bridegroom turned up, they were asleep and their lamps were out. We're to be more like those who were, many of them asleep, convalescing. There were about 300 troops, and about the same number of those convalescing and troop administrators, those not accustomed to fight. And when the moment came, they were awake to it. And so many of them gave their lives in that fierce battle of the tennis court. So in this Remembrance Tide, let's give thanks together in prayer and with our lives for those who gave up their lives for us. And remember those words of Jesus, to be awake, for you know not the hour. And that we might be awake, pray for that, awake to the moment for speaking up against racism, poverty, all those parts of our life together which diminish others, speaking up that God's kingdom of love, justice, and flourishing may come. From York, in Remembrance Tide, my warmest good wishes.